Hey, what up, everybody? This is Steve Breach coming to you. Good news out of the baseball world today is the Kansas City Royals have won the ALCS against the Baltimore Orioles, and they've moved on to their first World Series since 1985. I can honestly say that this year's Major League Baseball playoffs, I've been a little bit removed as a Major League Baseball Atlanta Braves fan. I just didn't feel it this year. I mean, the Atlanta Braves started out real hot in the National League East, and somewhere around July, it just seemed that we were the worst first-place team in baseball. We finally fell out of first place with the Washington Nationals picking up some games on us. It just seemed like every day we just lost and lost and lost, but the other teams were just losing as much as we were, so we were holding on to that lead in the East. I was only hoping that once we fell out of first and the second, that we would start to see the team sort of pick up and realize who they were. They never did. And one of the few years of being a Braves fan, that we're out of the playoffs. But honestly, I had a good smile on my face when I saw that, you know, these two teams are playing in the ALCS. Baltimore's a team that hasn't been really good in a long time. They put some playoff teams together throughout the 90s. But it just seems like they fell off into oblivion. The Royals, I always looked at them and the Pirates as two teams as I was growing up, just wondering what it was like to be a fan of those teams. And now those are two of the powerhouses in both leagues, really turning it around. You know, when I was a kid, I always looked at those two teams, and I was just like, as a fan, what do? When you wake up on opening day, you already know your season's over, and you don't even know what you're playing for. Why would you put your money into watching a team like that? But the Kansas City Royals strapped it up and put it together. A lot of this stuff is built around the Atlanta Braves. Of course, their general manager was a head scout at the Braves that moved over into that position, Ned Yost, a former third base coach of them. I remember flying to WrestleMania 27 in Atlanta, buying the ESPN magazine, and on the cover was a cover story about the Kansas City Royals winning the World Series within 2 years, and thinking that that was just some sort of a big joke, and they really put together, you know, what they were really doing as a franchise, building up their minor leagues and just getting these guys ready to get out there and play. It seems, looks like they're a year off from their goal, but I mean, they've already, clinched going in. They haven't lost a playoff game yet. The first real time all season I really paid attention to this team was that playoff game against the A's that went extra innings. I remember turning that game on when it was in the ninth because everybody in the world was talking about it on Twitter, and falling in love with that game. And just, this team really made big steps forward, with James Shields and Wade Davis coming over from the Tampa Bay Devil Rays in that trade that a lot of people thought they were crazy for giving up so many of their prospects. Myers and Montgomery being two of those guys. But, they put it together. They're going to be playing in their first World Series, and I can honestly tell you that's the team that I'm going to be rooting for. I think there's a lot of bandwagon jumpers on this team, but I really hope they're able to pull it off. I hope that this year the Royals are able to go on to that World Series and get this done. Already rumors about the Kansas City Royals losing their general manager. The Atlanta Braves are going to make a big play for him in the offseason since they fired their man. And they're still looking for somebody to fill Schurholz's shoes out there for you. I was wishing that as a Braves fan that we would have fired Freddy Gonzalez as well, but maybe that'll be next year. But, good luck to your Royals. Hopefully we steal your general manager and we can move on from here. Peace out, everybody.